Yo guys, welcome to a new video, and in this video I'm gonna talk to you guys about the season 5's meta. Here we go! What's up guys and girls, this is Patrick V and welcome to this video. In this video I'm gonna talk to you guys about the heroes who are in season 5's meta, but first, if you love watching competitive Overwatch videos with a little single player walkthroughs on the side, be sure to smash that subscribe button because that's what my channel is all about. And be sure to follow me on Twitter and Facebook for special announcements. Links are in the description below. This meta is based on the usage in the Overwatch pro scene, like TakeOver 2 and Contenders North America, but I also see a lot of teams use these heroes in the Overwatch World Cup. Here, I will show you a graph of the tiers based on the usage of the heroes. As you can see, no one is in the S tier. In tier 1, we have Lucio, Tracer and Winston. In tier 2, you can see Zenyatta, Soldier 76, Genji and D.Va. Ana is in tier 3. In tier 4 you can see Reinhardt, Zarya, Roadhog, Pharah, Sombra and Mercy. And last but definitely not least, in tier 5 you can see Widowmaker, Mei, McCree, Torbjorn, Bastion, Reaper, Hanzo, Orisa, Symmetra and Junkrat. This graph is based on the usage percentage by pros. Now I'm gonna say one sentence about the tier 1 and 2 heroes. Lucio is in tier 1 because of his nerf to his aura radius, prompting some teams are running Ana and Zenyatta defenses, and some teams also subbing Sombra in for Lucio on assault maps. Tracer. Never has it been a better meta to be a Tracer main since the implementation of one hero limit. Her movement makes her essential to dive comps, and her ability to blow up dive comps Zenyatta's make her a counter to her own best lineup. Winston. Winston provides the positional and cleave damage pressure required to soften up targets for Tracer and Genji's dash reset, so it's no surprise that he's the most popular tank in the weekend filled with European dive teams. Zenyatta. I will break down Zenyatta in a little bit. Soldier 76. If you want a long-ranged hit scan in the current meta, you need Soldier 76, who was completely unfazed by his slight nerf to his damage. Genji. Dash resets are the chain reaction that allows dive to push out the damage it needs. D.Va. D.Va is seen as a necessary evil by the pro scene. Her defense matrix continues to prevent Soldier 76 from running amok by countering nearly every tactical visor used. Now let's talk about Zenyatta. Zenyatta has steadily increased in usage over time, thanks in part to the nerf to Ana and rise of dive comps that rely on his Discord orbs. There is a whole new but also old element of gameplay on display by Zenyatta players, charged orb volleys, Relfing as it's called. These are map crossing volley kills. It's a method by which support players can change the course of an engagement in a split second. A fully charged orb volley can deal 230 damage across 5 orb hits, and this is before factoring in Discord orb or headshots. Relfing comes at a cost, however, as it takes 4 seconds to fully charge and cannot be held, meaning that executing this deadly blast requires precision timing and clever sightlines. Relfing may be the ultimate skill shot for Overwatch support heroes, beating out even Sleep Dart in terms of mid-fight impact. Sleep Dart can stop a Dragon's Blade in its tracks, sure, but a good Relf can delete a Genji from existence. So yeah, let me know guys what you think of this video and what you think about this meta. Maybe you would swap a couple of players. Just let me know in the comments below, and yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed watching this video and I will see you in the next one. Bye bye.
Ah, foutu la game, mais bon.
I've got you in my sights.
Tu es dans ma lune.